possibility. I mean, the first, which is from the periodic energy level, the metallic surface is the prototype. But in both of the cases, always the metallic layer is immobile because of the structural constraint. Of course, you can move by hand to the device, but I'm saying that relatively fixed in the structure. However, in the case of the model which I want to talk about, this can be moved, but still it also has a protected model metallic layer. That is what I'm going to talk about. So, actually, magnetic domain and the domain layer are also another good platform of the basis of double memory in the technology. And the domain layer also can be used as somehow two-dimensional extension of the topological space which is known in the system, the two domains of boundary links that are charged with inside. Now, the phase diagram of the indium oxide, as you saw many times, we have an AI type order, and the genes of different elements basically control the boundary ratio of the correlation strength. And it's known that they show the all-in-all-out type order. Now, there are many years strain experimentalism which inspired us to give us motivation to work on this problem. First, the optical conductivity shows a very small gap, as you saw in the previous talk, and this is in contrast with the typical motor shape in 3D oversight type systems. And actually, related to the problem of the crystal, some crystal, the interface shows somehow very low in hoping type conduction instead of Arrhenius type behavior. Another weird experimental result is it shows a very weak ferromagnetic moment, as you heard in the previous talk, and the moment of the weak ferromagnetic moment, it is very slow, it is only 1 second, where it fell, and it also shows somehow very interesting, very strong negative magnetic resistance. So all of these show some kind of battery saving here, but that matter is very famous terminology, but this is a sort of very battery saving compound. Now, from the theoretical point of view, one is obvious here. It's a simply allowed the more general one, where we take a haplotype model, so this is because the electron correlation is substantial. Also, we need to use spin orbit interaction, and this is one which is the most general simply allowed form, that we have an independent hobby. Now, in terms of other parallels, it turned out that this is very special because depending on the sign of theta, if theta is positive, it immediately goes to the topological theta. So the gap opens at the same level here. However, if theta, this is spin orbit interaction, theta becomes negative, then the topological theta doesn't appear and the quadratic transaction is realized. So this is the basic phase diagram where as a function of interaction and the spin orbit interaction, if theta is positive, we immediately have a topological insert that in the negative theta with a quadratic transaction. If the interaction effect becomes large, then we realize all that order, and actually we can, if we take a strong coupling expansion in terms of the key value of theta over t, then negative Gaussian familiar type interaction comes out and this type of AI order can be explained. There is different interesting to here, but let us skip this part. Now, let's look at on negative theta, because this is a case, realistic case, in outer limit. Actually, theta should be negative in the most of the compound. Now, if the magnetic error appears, then the system seems to be trivial, but these people proposed that the system is not trivial and the right hand that appears. I discussed many times in this conference. However, this light metal is a rather fragile, and if you increase lower the temperature, then these two appear at right points, make a fair annihilation, and the gapless point disappears, and that will seem to be disappearing insulator eventually. So, the prime question is, does the all-in-all-out order state become a trivial with insulator at low temperature? Apparently, this doesn't explain the weird strange experimental results, which I mentioned before. So, the question is, what happens after the peer annihilation of right points? So, our proposal is that the domain is playing a crucial role in this physics. And first, we have to propose that the domain explains how the system explains the proposal. And I want to tell you that this is a sort of new proposal insert protected by some special kind of symmetry. And then we explain about the domain which is perpendicular to the normal direction. Now, the all-in-all order and the domain including the manual, is not the symmetry of the original parabola, which is a product of inversion and unilateral symmetry. It also preserves the threefold symmetry and the y-1 direction in the case of this manual. And that gives you a good quantum number for the y-1 component of the total angular momentum, and that can be plus minus half or plus minus how it doesn't kind of happen along this line that goes to that Madonna because of that symmetry. Now, if magnetic order is zero, this is the paramagnetic situation, we have basically eight bands, but they are doubly degenerate. And the reason is because of karma degeneracy. So the reason why we have eight bands is that we have four types of iridium in unit form, so the tetrahedron, and it has a speed with them, so we have eight components, and they have four doubly degenerate bands. Now, in a magnetic order phase, karma degeneracy is put, and then we have eight bands. Now the second order is this is a band of the J-effective half system. So if the degeneracy is split, then in the rest, what happens is that we have these splitting. Now the red band represents the quantum number of the number one component of the angular momentum plus half, and the blue one is minus half. So plus half and minus half, then the degeneracy is here, and we also have a J-3 half band here. And we need to have the splitting of the degeneracy region of the gamma point. We need to have a crossing of this blue band and this blue half band. That generates light point here. And with the increase of OIO order, that splitting becomes larger and larger. And that means this light splitting point becomes far and far and eventually disappear in air at all points. That is the situation where we have annihilation of light points. Okay, so however, this band structure is a band structure in one domain. If you see the other side of the domain, we have domain over here, and one domain, and then the other side, blue and red must be inverse because of switching. Then if you see below the same level, we have two blue bands and one red band. That gives you the chi number, and in the other side of the domain, the number must be inverse. And because of that, we need to cross the band at the domain position, and that makes the surface excitation, which is the only limit of the metallic surface at the domain wall. So it's a sort of three-dimensional class A chi number exists, and that gives you the symmetry protected the domain of metallic surface. Now, in the domain, if the magnetic order, AIO order, develops, then first, in the near the critical temperature, the arc, semi arc at the domain wall is slow. And complementary, at the surface, we have another semi arc. But with the evolution of the magnetic order, this point goes to the L point here next year, and then eventually disappears. Accordingly, this semi arc disappears. But this semi arc grows, and eventually it makes a closed semi surface. That is the reason why, even below the disappearance of the semi light points, we have a remaining semi surface on the magnetic domain wall.
Yeah,
this is the sort of the projection. I mean, the inner arc in two dimensional. So here is the
other part of the arc, and then the other part of the arc. And then, usually
you're hearing earlier, there are
two surfaces. One
of them
has part of the arc, the other has the other.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think?
Mm-hmm. Do you think something? Yeah, if you have two surfaces, then you have this surface structure here. So if you have the surface here, then you have another complementary frame surface, or arc. Another interesting observation is this domain wall has a not uniform magnetic version, but because of that can be controlled by magnetic field. If you apply magnetic field, then you can move this domain wall very easily. Now, when the AIO order develops, first the back-end surface and the domain wall is degenerate. But the order develops, eventually that helical degenerate from the surface becomes split into this red one and the blue one. Eventually, we have this kind of two helical metallic surface. And the order grows even further, even more. Then what happens is that object shrinks and shrinks and disappears at k and k becomes point. That leads to eventually the trivial magnetic inflator. Now, this is that kind of phase diagram. So, starting from the paramagnetic metal, first we generate the degenerate helical metal first with increase of U in this case, but it can be replaced with the temperature lower in that direction. And what happens is that we first have the density state here. So this is the memory will be the final density with the same surface. And interesting is that if we have anomalous quantum Hall effect given by red square and blue circle. If you don't have a domain wall, then the blue surface shows that in the helical metal, we don't have that. But in the domain wall, we have an anomalous quantum Hall effect. That means this anomalous contribution is coming from the domain wall. So this shows the frequency dependence of the CMX light anomaly. And depending on the magnetic field, it shows some broad band structure continuum. But by scaling by the magnetic field, it is in a graph with a single curve. That means this has a very specific scaling, which is that is in contrast to the normal case of lambda level attack contribution. Because of the helical mental formation, we also expect circular macroism, and actually the circular macroism defined in this quantity shows again some characteristic peak structure, and there is a normal quantum Hall effect, and the circular macroism is our prediction, which should be measured in a particular Hilbert at low temperature in the case of the European in the flow bandwidth systems. So the inner motivation of balance data is more explained. First, the very bad interesting behavior is mainly coming from the conduction at the domain wall. And my vision and skills. I should say that it feels the place here. Although I'm the tiny moon, I feel some strange, wrong time test here.
Not to get extra time in sharing that.